and welcome to My Finance Teacher. Today I want to talk to you guys about the potential in crude oil, both in longer term as well as in the short term. So I want to start with this weekly chart where I'm trying to show intermediate cycles over the last 4 years, 2015, 16, 17, and 18. And in these last 4 years, we've had around 8 intermediate cycles. So on average, these intermediate or weekly cycles in crude oil seem to last for about half a year, and they often seem to break above the 20-week moving average on the ascend and break below that 20-week moving average during the declining phase. The current intermediate cycle has only been going on for a couple of months since December. So there is still a lot of potential within this intermediate cycle in the medium term to bring crude oil price to relatively higher levels. I'm expecting somewhere around 64, as there is some resistance level around that price. So in the intermediate term, over the next several months, I am bullish on crude oil, and I see some confirmation on the news. OPEC has cut its production to the lowest levels since 2015. And Russia, although it is taking time to comply with OPEC requests, is planning to cut its production as well over the next several months, coincidentally. Another thing that also makes me relatively bullish on crude oil over the next several months is this performance in S&P 500 or the US economy in general. As one of the viewers commented on one of the previous videos on my channel, there is quite a bit of a correlation between the S&P 500 with crude oil. That, of course, is quite logical. As economies expand, stock markets would expand as well, and greater economic activity would lead to greater demand for crude oil, leading to price rises as well. So it is quite logical, and I thank you guys for all your comments you provide. And looking at intermediate cycles in S&P 500, again, over the last 3 years, that's 2016, 17, 18, we've seen 6 intermediate cycles. So they on average last for about half a year, although sometimes they can be stretched for quite a long time, as the previous one did. And the current one, again, has only been going on since December last year. That gives us only a couple of months. So there is still some potential within the current intermediate cycle in S&P 500 to continue upward. And I think it is going to break above 2800 sometime over the next several months. So if there is some correlation between stock markets, economic performance, and the price of crude oil, this would be another factor that makes me bullish on crude oil in the medium term, over the next several months. And in fact, there is some correlation. Again, thanks to one of the viewers' comments, I looked at the weekly data. This is a scatter plot between S&P 500 data and the crude oil price all through 2016, 17, and 18. And based on this data, the correlation index is 0.877. Greater numbers on the S&P 500 correlate, not necessarily cause, but they do correlate with generally greater numbers on crude oil price. So that makes me, again, as I said, bullish on crude oil over the medium term. I want to emphasize that, because the same thing also makes me cautious, maybe even a little bit bearish on crude oil over the shorter term, over the next several weeks rather than several months. This is S&P 500 on the daily chart. This current cycle hasn't had any significant corrections yet, and we are due for some sort of a correction, especially given that RSI has already dipped slightly into overbought territory. So, although I am bullish on S&P 500 and crude oil in the medium term over the next several months, however, I am cautious on S&P 500 and crude oil over the next couple of weeks, Although S&P 500 might continue rising over the next several days as the resistance level of 2800 is still above the current levels. I think there is some possibility that S&P 500 might correct back towards possibly 50-day moving average. Plus, out of the recent decline all the way from October to December 2018, we've already retraced slightly more than 62%. That's a 62% Fibonacci retracement. So again, I am cautious on S&P 500 and crude oil over the next couple of weeks. Continuing with this topic of being cautious with crude oil, this is the daily chart of crude oil, and this is how I see daily cycles on this chart. As you see from the marks here, these daily cycles last for about 2 to 3 months. And the current daily cycle in crude oil has already been going on for about a month and a half. So if this daily cycle turns out to be a relatively short one, if it only lasts for a couple of months rather than 3 months, then it means there isn't that much time left for this current cycle to go into its declining phase. And it might have already started, as RSI is showing some divergence. And we've seen relatively lower prices over the last several days. Although several days is not much of an indication, and we'll have to see what happens to crude oil over the next couple of weeks. Besides that, looking at Fibonacci retracement, the recent decline since October to December has already been retraced to the extent of 38% over here. And 38% is one of those Fibonacci numbers that might turn out to be a resistance zone. And as I mentioned, crude oil has already started dropping over the last several days, and possibly this drop will continue over the next couple of weeks, especially as US inventory of crude oil seems to be rising at the moment. Although remember, I don't expect this drop in crude oil to be severe, as we are still in an advancing phase of the intermediate cycle. So possibly crude oil retests this 50-day moving average and bounces up from there. And on the personal note, I've recently sold my USO positions at about 11:30, and I will be looking forward to buy them back if crude oil retests 50-day moving average. And I think if not, I will still be looking forward to buy that USO position back. And how about you? What is your favorite way of investing in crude oil? Let me know in the comments below. Maybe I'll have a chance to try your investment vehicle as well. Remember, this is not investment advice. I'm just sharing my opinion with you. And I thank you for listening to my opinion and wish you a nice day.